So dear students, we have seen CPU and its types in our last section. Today we will see memory, which is the important part of hardware architecture of embedded system. So memory is also component of the hardware architecture of embedded system. Basically two categories of memories are there, that is program memory and data memory. So program memory is a permanent memory and data memory is a temporary memory. Program memory is a memory where the programs that are to be executed are saved, and that's why it is called as the permanent memory, because it contains all the programs that we want to execute. Whereas data memory contains the data which will be needed for the execution of tasks, and that's why it is called as the temporary memory. So the memory is again divided into various parts, that is RAM, ROM and hybrid memory. So RAM is nothing but the random access memory. So as its name implies, the random access memory can be read as well as changed according to the data and the machine code. It allows us to read and write the data almost the same amount of time irrespective of the physical location of data inside the memory. So by using random access memory, we can read and write the data. Basically, RAM contains multiplexing and demultiplexing circuitry, and it connects the data lines to the address storage for reading and writing the entry, because random access memory is responsible for reading and writing both. So RAM is normally associated with the volatile types of memory, where the information, where the stored information is lost if the power is removed. Basically, there are two types of RAM, SRAM and DRAM, that is static random access memory and dynamic random access memory. So static random access memory, that is nothing but SRAM, a bit of data is stored using the transistor memory cell in the SRAM. This SRAM is expensive to produce, but it is faster. Whereas SRAM is often used as cache memory for CPU. We have seen now in our last section in CPU, cache memory was also used. So SRAM is often used as cache memory for CPU. Whereas DRAM is nothing but dynamic random access memory. It stores the bit of data using a transistor and capacitor pair, which together combines or comprises the DRAM cell. So this form of memory is less expensive than the static RAM. Both static and dynamic RAM are considered as volatile, as their state is lost or reset when power is removed from the system. So that is nothing but RAM, that is nothing but random access memory, which is responsible for reading and writing the data, as well as we have seen the types of RAM, that is random access memory, SRAM and DRAM. So the next memory is called as ROM. So ROM is nothing but read-only memory. Now, as its name implies, it permits for reading the data only. We can only read the data in read-only memory. It is the non-volatile memory which is used in the computers. So whatever data is stored in ROM cannot be electronically modified after the manufacturing of the memory device. ROM is useful for storing the software that is rarely changed, and that's why it is also called as firmware. Now the types of ROM are PROM. PROM is nothing but programmable read-only memory. So programmable read-only memory can be written or programmed via the special device which is called as the PROM programmer. Typically, PROM uses high voltages to destroy or create the links within the chip. The next memory is EPROM, that is Erasable Programmable Read Only Memory. So this Erasable Programmable Read Only Memory erases by exposure to strong ultraviolet light, then re-written with a process that again needs the higher voltage. And that's why EPROM chips exceeds 1000 cycles of erasing and reprogramming. So these are the basic types of ROM. Now hybrid memory mainly contains EEPROM. Now EEPROM is nothing but electrically erasably programmable read only memory. It is almost similar to EPROM, but what is the difference that EEPROM allows its entire contents to be electrically erased and then rewritten electrically. So that is the difference between EPROM and PROM. Now the next is flash memory. Flash memory is also modern type of EEPROM memory. Flash memory can be erased and rewritten faster than the EEPROM memory, and its main feature is high endurance. So flash memory is mainly durable and it is more faster. That's why flash memory is also called as the hybrid memory. So EPROM is type of ROM, and EEPROM is the hybrid memory which is responsible for electrically erasable, which electrically erases the contents of our memory. So according to the need of our system, the particular memory is used. Hybrid memory also contains one type of memory which is called as non-volatile memory. The non-volatile memory is the memory that can retrieve the stored information even after the power is cycled. So it needs volatile memory needs the constant power, but non-volatile memory is basically the memory which can be retrieved even after the power cycle has been done. So basically the non-volatile memory refers to the storage in semiconductor memory chips as well as flash memory, EEPROM. So that is nothing but non-volatile RAM. So in this section we have studied detailedly RAM, ROM and hybrid memory, which is the part of our hardware architecture. In our next section, we will see the next components of the hardware architecture of embedded system. Thank you.